Now, this feels a little nicer. I don't know if there's weeds on the hook or just what, but this has a little bit more weight to it. It might just be... Oh no, this is a nice fish. Oh boy.
How often have you been watching a fishing show on TV and wondered if that presenter ever had a slow day? What do you do if the spike don't seem to be biting? Are there strategies that a fisherman can use to increase his odds of catching a nice fish or two? I'm certainly not declaring myself an expert, but I do have a couple ideas you might want to try the next time that you have a slow day. The lake I chose for this outing is well managed, with limited access. There is good numbers of pike and a few members in the lake that are over 40 inches. Full of confidence, I struck out onto the ice. Last summer, I accessed this lake with my canoe, and using the auto chart zero line function of my Hummingbird Helix 7 fish locator, I produced a contour map of the bottom. The chart revealed a tantalizing small bar protruding from a weedy edge on shore. Adjacent to the bar was a cat-tailed line bay with deeper water. I identified this bar as the perfect place to sight fish, or so I thought. Using the GPS function of my Helix, I started drilling holes along the top of the bar in depths of 4 to 7 feet. Using my coat as a shroud, I peered down into the holes looking to identify the edge of the weed line. My goal was to set up my shelter over the top of the bar at the deep edge of the weed line, hoping to get a few passing shots at larger pike as they worked their way along the weed edge. While getting organized, I normally put out my tip-ups, and this day was no exception. I placed the tip-ups where the water depth was 4.5 feet and set the depth of my bait to stay above the weeds. Within 2 minutes, I landed my first fish. I was so confident of a good day that I took the tip up out of surface temporarily. After all, I didn't want to burn through all my sucker minnows too quickly. Once I had everything organized and my sight hole open, I got to fishing. I jigged with my marabou dragon tail lures. I tried silicone and dragon tails, silicone and swim baits. I even tried rabbit zonker and minnows. After several hours, I hadn't even had a pike follow my lure. It was now 1 p.m. And with just a couple hours of daylight left, it was time to change tactics. Using my Hummingbird, I drilled a line of holes at a water depth of 4.5 feet, parallel with the shore. After allowing the areas around the holes to calm down, I jigged in each hole. Still nothing. I was still getting an occasional flag from the tip-up set up in shallow water, however. As daylight waned, I gave up on jigging entirely and placed a second tip-up over weeds, speculating that the fish desired a static minnow presentation and no foot traffic around the tip-ups.
Well, this fish ran the entire spool out by the time I saw it. I'm pulling up a lot of weight. My guess is he got into the weeds. Pretty nice fish. Okay. It's a fairly nice fish. They're pretty skinny though. 22, 23 inch fish.
My day was coming to an end. It was 3 o'clock in the afternoon, and it was time to pack it in. Just before I removed my tip-ups from the water, my patience paid off, and I was rewarded with this nice 29-inch pike. So what did I learn from this outing? A couple of things immediately come to mind. If you're not having any luck with what you normally do, don't be afraid to try a new tactic. Granted, some days the fish have lockjaw and you're going to have a tough day. But sometimes a change in tactics may be productive. What do you have to lose? Try something new. Secondly, patience, patience, patience. Sometimes you just got to wait them out. Fish typically don't feed all day long, not even northerns. We've all been on the water when you can't buy a bite, and then suddenly.
Put that down for a catch. A little farther out.
I don't have a quarrel with you, teacher. We've been doing this all night. Nothing. All right. At your word.
The boat, it's still out!